That's the first topic for this session. In this topic, we'll be saying how do you estimate working capital requirements. We'll be dividing into trading concern and for a manufacturing concern. We know what is working capital, current assets minus current liability. So let's see for current assets minus current liabilities, how do you do for a trading concern? Keep it simple when you're estimating the working capital requirements for the future. Same thing, you need to follow current assets minus current liability. Current assets can be cash in hand, cash in bank, bills receivable, closing stock. Similarly, current liabilities can be creditors, outstanding expenses, bills payable. So current assets minus current liabilities gives you working capital. Add up any provision for contingency, you get net working capital requirement. It's very simple. How do you do for a trading concern? Keep it simple, current assets minus current liabilities. But a manufacturing concern, we need to go deep into it. When a manufacturing company happens, these type of stocks which they have, remember the operating cycle? They have a stock for raw material, work in progress and finished good. So when they are finding out the current assets, in current assets you need to divide the stock of raw material, stock of work in progress, stock of finished good. Similarly, stock of work in progress, finished good can be again for raw material, direct labor and indirect cost which is required for work in progress. Similarly, for finished good, how much are raw materials required, labor is required and how much are indirect expenses. Similarly, for debtors, how much is raw material, direct labor or indirect cost involved. So if you see, when you start manufacturing, divide your goods for a manufacturing company into raw material, work in progress and finished goods, what happened? In work in progress and finished goods stage, again you have to have stock, again you have to have labor for them, and again expenses need to be incurred. So we divide our current assets into three parts. Stock, again you have closing stock, you have debtors, you have cash in hand, cash in bank, everything remain the same. The stock has to be divided into three heads, that is raw material, work in progress and finished goods. Work in progress and finished good will have their own expenses, will have their own cost, for example, for labor, for indirect expenses, for stock, include them. Same way how you do current assets minus current liabilities, minus any current liabilities, we have bills payable, outstanding expenses, what do you get? Working capital, add up any provision for contingency for future, is a net working capital requirement. This is how you estimate the working capital requirement for trading concern and a manufacturing concern. Keep it simple, current assets minus current liabilities, both you have to do for trading or manufacturing, but manufacturing, the stock needs to be divided for work in progress, raw material and finished goods.